You help run a small inn at a quiet corner of the Roman Empire. One afternoon, a rider on horseback approaches. The rider gives you a note. It reads, "Innkeeper, tonight you will have XLVIII soldiers spending the night at your inn. Please start making arrangements for our stay." You recognize the letters, but you don't know how Romans count, so you take it to the manager, who does. She said, "Romans probably started counting using a line for each item, and it gets cumbersome after a few items, so they use different letters to represent different numbers. I is for 1, V is for 5, X is for 10, L is for 50, C is for 100, D is for 500, and M represents 1,000. You feel relieved it won't be hundreds of Romans. That'd be more than we could handle. She continued, "The order of the letters matters too. From 1 to 3, it's just dashes. So I, and III. But 4 is different. 4 is IV, which is 1 less than 5. 5 is V, and then 6, 7, and 8 are VI, VII, and VIII, respectively. The extra ones added on the right. Do you want to guess what 9 is? I guess IX? That's right. So 11 is XI, 12 is XII, 13 is XIII, 14 is XIV, and so on. Tens and fifties are the same as ones and fives. It's the same for hundreds and 500. XL is 10 less than 50, so 40 plus VIII means there are 48 soldiers arriving. You're relieved it's not too many, but it'll be a lot. The manager asks, "It's a tough one, but how many would MMCXCVI be?" You pause for a bit. MMCXCVI. M is 1,000, and there's 2 of them, so 2,000. C is 100, so 2,100. XC is 10 less than 100, so 90. We're at 2,190. And VI is 6, so 2,196. "Spot on," she said. "I'll clean up the guest area. Can you go sweep out the barn? And on your way, tell the chef to start making a large stew. We've got a lot to do before they arrive."